Hey guys, it's me, Delta One, here with Airsoft Talk, and today I'm bringing you a video brought to you by Techstar Airsoft, and today we are going to take a look at my personal thoughts and opinions on the CYMA 1911 AAP. Again guys, make sure you tag that notification bell so you get notified when I make a video. Again, there's other people here at the store I'm at right now, so I apologize if you can hear any noise in the background. So, anyways, my personal thoughts, if you've watched any of my videos over a long period of time, you know that I love AEPs. I've never been too fond of gas pistols. That just, to me, it's just, I'm just not a fan. I prefer to have electric because to me it feels a little more reliable. But that's my opinion, and wow, my camera does not like focusing. Anyways, so one of the things you're probably going to notice about this 1911 is it is fairly large. To give you an idea of how wide it is, that's a computer mouse. So it's pretty wide because if you pull this little lever down, the slide catch, you pull off, you can see the gearbox right there. It is fairly small, but that's where your battery goes and is housed in here. So that's where the lever is, pulls the battery out. Now it is a bit off scale, like really off scale, like I don't know how else to explain it. It's fat. But if that doesn't deter you, I can tell you this. This is one of the things I like about these is they're quiet. And with all this extra room in here, you can go and buy like a little LiPo and wire it in directly. I don't, however, really recommend that unless you're a technician like me or you're a tech, because directly wiring batteries is never a great idea in my opinion. There's always things that could go wrong, especially when they're LiPos. So now the whole thing is metal and it's finished off with some paint that was probably put on by some little kid in China who's crying and sweating. But other than that, you got plastic grips, you have fully automatic and semi-automatic, which I don't have a battery in here, but they are compatible with the Glock AEP Max, and they're not bad. I don't know if the extended one would fit in here, but if it does, that would be awesome. However, God, it really annoys me, that thing that does that. However, this doesn't really do anything except go clank. But the overall construction isn't bad. I honestly prefer these. Like, I would rather have one of these over a gas pistol. I also prefer, it's the same gearbox as the Scorpion, the Mac 11 or Mac 10 that's out that JG's finally cloned and gotten together. The sights, they're as bland as always. Not really super superb, but I mean, for something that you're quiet, if you're a sniper or you're in a CQB field, you can make these really, really work for you because they're so quiet. And they're small and they're inexpensive, which is great. So when you use one of these, if it ever broke, you're not really like hurting. You can go buy another one because they're fairly inexpensive. They're not like a WE pistol where they're anywhere from 100 to 100 and something, I don't know, almost $200 for the like crazy good ones, I guess. But these are fairly inexpensive. The range isn't as good as a gas pistol, but then yet again, if you're pulling out a sidearm, like, do you really need 200 feet? I mean, you're going up close. So this is a good option, in my opinion. I would prefer this over any gas pistol that I can buy. So that's just me. Now, one of the only things that kind of concerns me is the slide lever here. This is how you open and close. You hear that click? That's what opens and holds this shut. And it looks like that. So if you were to accidentally knock this, you could accidentally, you know, this could accidentally possibly fall off. So there's that. But in all honesty, functionality comes first to me over a looks. I've never been a big fan of oh, it's got to look perfect. Oh, you know, if the battery doesn't fit inside the gun, it looks tacky. I'm not going to prom. Why does it matter? So, I mean, if it was up to me, if I could, I would wire this up to it with Dean's and run a pouch. If it wasn't so large and, heavy and stuff. But I've seen people who run wires, up into their sleeve like this, into a pouch that's somewhere on their arm. And they run these as, a primary, which I think is awesome. Upgrade parts are a little scarce. I've never, ever attempted to take one of these apart. But I think it would be really cool. I would love to upgrade one and get the trigger response there and run an 11-1. I've seen someone do that with an AEP. However, he did run the battery out of the gun from what I saw. Let's put this back together. But yeah, so you have to make sure you push that up or else, there's that. You got a little lanyard mount right here. Personally, I wouldn't trust it. But I would use it just in case, it falls out. But again, this is huge. It's so big. Like it's wider than a double stack high kappa. I'm trying to think of something I can use for a reference that would be showing how wide it is. Ah, here we go. Here's a Coke can, right? It is literally almost 60% as wide as a Coke can. So, yeah. Honestly, though, I like it. I would use it. Again, they're inexpensive. They're quiet. That's its strongest point right there. And obviously it does not look to scale and it doesn't look as real, but in all honesty, these are the type of guns that I love using and people love using because it's I got you out with that. Got you out with this. How humiliating is that? And that's honestly my favorite part about these little things is that you can humiliate people. One of my favorite airsoft games I've ever played was that someone made the claim that rate of fire, if you have a higher rate of fire, you're automatically going to win. And I took a SEMA Glock 18 and a Well Scorpion. It was 5v5, the entire other team had 40 RPS guns. In 21 seconds, I took out their entire team. I killed 5 people with a little AEP, just like this. So, there's that. Again, guys, I'm a little rusty in making videos. I'm still getting the hang of things. So, excuse me if I'm a little all over the place. Now, with this one, I will say over the other AEPs on the market that you can buy, you do have a lot more room to work with in the slide comparatively to, one of the Glocks, which are much, 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 much more restricted in terms of battery space, which is why I kind of like this thing, because it's this takes the same mags, I can put a bigger battery in it, the battery terminals are right here, and my camera's not really high quality. You can focus, there you go, that's where it slides in, and I've seen people take these apart and put in regular mini connectors or something like that, but you have much more room to work with than the Glocks do. So I like that. And unfortunately it didn't come with a threaded barrel. If it came with a threaded barrel, that'd be awesome. Now the hop-ups on these are decent. I mean, they're not amazing. I mean, I wouldn't expect anything beyond 100 feet. I mean, at that point, you're really lobbing it. So, and then it's always fun to pull this mag out. You're like, oh, it's a 1911. and then you pull that itty bitty mag out. So in all honesty, guys, I do recommend this. It does have its cons, it does have its downfalls, but in all honesty, it would make a good sidearm for someone who needs to be quiet. Now, if you're sniping and you want an electric, this is a good option to go with, because I know you don't want to give away your position. However, it doesn't have the distance, but if you're that close, you can pick people off far away enough to where they won't be able to tell where you are if they don't talk. So I honestly like these things. They're fairly inexpensive. On the high side, they're like $70. On the low side, I've seen, you know, I don't know, 60, maybe even cheaper. And they're really good. Like, internally, they're really overbuilt. I wouldn't worry about stripping a gear. I wouldn't worry about stripping your motor, or even the piston, for that matter. I've never seen someone strip a piston when I lent one of mine out. Mine just locked up because I fried the motor by trying to hook up a battery I shouldn't have been hooking up to it. And I bypassed it because I didn't put a fuse. So, but that's my thoughts, guys. Again, I would recommend it. It's kind of a niche item. You know, if you're trying to be quiet, you're a sniper, or if you just want a giggle gun to get someone out with, this is honestly one of the better options. But again, guys, if you enjoyed my video, go add me on Facebook, check out TechStar's Instagram, and make sure to click on that notification bell so you get notified when I post videos, and please leave a like. Other than that, life is good, and see you in the next video.